Well, I've never had anyone except what I call the Jurassic Park singers object to it. Once you have the people like Domingo and so forth, would they? No, I don't think Alfredo would do that. And you think, listen, dear, Alfredo is a fictional character. He doesn't exist. Let's find a performance of someone who might do that. And I can assure you that if we're in the period in which we're going to set it, that's probably what he would wear or what she would wear. Well, it's quite difficult with some of these megastars, again, who are just international travelers. Rather, they're applauded for their voices. Their acting is usually terrible. But most of the people I've worked with are delightful. I mean, I've often said to be this spiteful person who attacks and criticises his casts. There are only about five people about whom I say adverse things. And I say adverse things because they deserve it, because they're stupid and they're powerful and they are, in the opera world, given undue attention. And where it's very hard to get anything on other than what they want to wear. And they're from the Jurassic Park. They're accustomed to wearing the traditional clothes, which are themselves vulgar versions of the past in which it is apparently set. Even if you set it in the past of, say, 1450, and dress it accurately in the costumes of the 1450s, they wouldn't wear it. What they want to wear are Victorian versions of 1450. It's what I call Madame Tussaud history. But that's on the whole, I don't think I've ever encountered real objections from 95% of the casts with whom I work, who find it delightful and challenging and interesting to see it that way. I did a production, for example, a couple of years ago, of a famous opera by Janáček, which I did in upstate New York in Glimmerglass. Now, it takes place apparently in the Czech community in Czechoslovakia, round near to Brno, where Janáček was writing. Well, I don't like peasant costumes on the whole on the stage. I think they just look sort of kitsch. But then I had been reading some years before, and this is the way these things bubble up. I was reading without a view to an opera. I was reading the novels of, what's her name? The American novelist who writes, amongst things, about the Czech community living in Nebraska. And so I thought, I know what when I was asked to do this Janúška, I said, I know what I'll do. I'll set it in 1930. In the Czech community in Nebraska, written in these novels. I'll remember her name in a minute. Novels like My Antonia and O Pioneer and things like that. They were wonderful, wonderful novels. Huge, huge success. Completely ignored by the American critics who never came to see it. But it was wonderful, very, very good. And many people came and saw it and just said, oh God, how stupid not to have thought of that.